Hey guys, today for the review we have the TESMEN TCM-300A. We received this multimeter from the TESMEN company to make a review. It's the TESMEN TCM-300A Smart Digital Meter. Let's start with the unboxing. It comes with a nice branded case. It comes with a multilingual manual. Inside the case, there are the probe leads, the thermocouple for temperature readings, three AAA batteries, and the clamp meter. Remove the back cover to insert the three AAA batteries. Remove the plastic film from the display. Remove the protective caps from the multimeter probe ends. Insert the black probe to the COM port. Insert the red probe to the input port. Remove the protective caps from the multimeter probe leads. Press and hold the power button to turn off the multimeter. Press it again to turn the multimeter back on. By default, when you turn on the meter, it's in auto mode. The supported measurements in auto mode are current, AC/DC voltage, resistance, and continuity. To do other measurements, press the function button. The first option is to measure current. The next is AC/DC voltage. The next is resistance. The next is continuity. The next is to do diode test. The next is millivolt. The next is to measure hertz. The next is to measure capacitance. The next is to detect non-contact AC voltage. When you press the function button again, it goes back to the auto mode. On the left is the trigger button to open the clamp. This is used to measure amperage of an AC signal. I will show how this is used later in this video. On the right side, if you hold this button, the flashlight will turn on. The flashlight is at the top. This feature comes in handy when you're working in a dimly lit area. It's time to start testing what this clamp meter can do. I'm going to start in auto mode. The first test is to check the voltage of this AA battery. This is a new battery, so it should have around 1.5 volts. When I touch the probes to the battery, this meter automatically detects I'm checking voltage. The reading shows around 1.5 volts, which is a good sign. Another option is to use manual mode and specify the voltage setting. This is done by pressing the function button until you're at the voltage setting. You get the same reading, but there are additional steps in the manual mode. The next test is to test this red alligator clip for continuity. Since I want to switch back from manual to auto mode, I'm going to keep pressing the function button until I see auto on the display. I know this alligator clip is good, so I should hear a beep. I hear a beep, so there is continuity. The alarm indicator has a green light, which is another sign there is continuity. The next test is to do the diode test. In auto mode, the meter wants to do a resistance test. Since we want to do a diode test, I have to press the function button to switch to manual mode and select the diode setting. The reading shows around 0.6, so this is a good diode. The meter is very quick in returning the value. The next test is to do the resistance test. This is a 470 ohms resistor. Press the function button again to switch back to auto mode. When I touch the probe leads to the resistor, the reading shows around 468 ohms, which is close to the expected value. The next test is to do the capacitance test. This capacitor has a capacitance of 47 microfarads. Press the function button to switch to the capacitance setting. When I touch the probe leads to the capacitor, the reading shows around 45 microfarads. The next test is to do the current measurement. I have a portable air filter that plugs into a wall outlet. As seen in the specs, it requires an input of 120 volts and 0.56 amps. Press the trigger and insert the power cable inside the clamp. There shouldn't be any amps showing yet. I'm turning on the air filter. The link to this clamp meter is in the description. When I have the air filter on, the reading shows around 0.55 amps. The next test is to do the AC voltage measurement. I have a power strip that is connected to the wall outlet. I'm going to insert the probe leads into the receptacles. The reading shows 119 volts and around 60 hertz. This is expected for a standard electrical wall outlet found in US homes. The next test is to do the non-contact AC voltage detection. Press the function button to switch to the NCV setting. The tip of the meter is the NCV probe. I have a power cable that is connected to a light source. I'm going to point the NCV probe to the power cable. The letter L display and the buzzer indicates a weak electric field signal. The alarm indicator also shows a green light. The next test is to do the temperature measurement. The meter comes with the K-type thermocouple. Insert the black pole into the COM port. Insert the red pole into the input port. Press the function button to toggle to the temperature setting. The temperature currently shows around 18 degrees Celsius. If I light the measurement junction with a lighter, the temperature should increase. The reading goes as high as 482 degrees Celsius. This is a great clamp meter. It's packed with functionality. When you turn on the meter, it's in the smart mode, which makes it fast and easy to start measuring voltage, resistance, or continuity. It has good accuracy. It's a great value. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about electronics, be sure to like, subscribe, and explore the links in the description for more detailed videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.